And good morning, everybody. Thank you for joining with us for this exclusive Business Alliance presentation from Thames Valley Chamber of Commerce. It gives me great pleasure to advise that today's event sponsors are long-standing Business Alliance members Activate Learning and BMW Group. We are delighted to extend a warm Thames Valley Chamber welcome to our invited special guests and friends, including our Chamber CEO, Mr. Paul Britton. We are in great company here today, ladies and gentlemen, with representatives drawn from cross-sector, and we are excited that some of the region's largest employers have their key personnel join with us in the room here today. Given the calibre in the room, I'm confident we have a great demography that will lend itself brilliantly to a great presentation as we explore further the talent agenda faced by organisations in this brave new world of 2021. Today, we will be hearing from five guest speakers. From Activate Learning, we are delighted to introduce Mark Byerley, Director of Career Pathways, Scott Riley, Director of Curriculum Design for Technology, Holly Parrott, Partnership Engagement Manager at Activate Learning, and also Jennifer Robinson, Project Coordinator. And lastly, I'd like to introduce Mark Mazingham, Digital Industries Trainer at BMW Group. As we move through the presentation this morning, there will be a couple of poll questions also, and we invite you to insert your answers accordingly, and also, of course, to please populate the chat function with questions and comments as we go through the presentation. At the back end, we will group questions for pickup by the panel, and we look forward to visiting that on the Q&A. We do hope, of course, that you enjoyed this morning's presentation and invite you to share contacts and introduce yourselves in the chat box as well. So over to our first speaker, Scott Riley. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning, Adrian, and good morning, everyone. Good to see you all, and thank you very much indeed for giving up your valuable time to myself and my colleagues this morning. And just wait for the slides to follow. Thank you very much. So I'll be giving you a curriculum overview of some of the programmes that we have on offer within Activate Learning, and specifically within our Faculty of Technology. Okay, so at Activate Learning, and more specifically the Technology Faculty, our curriculum is at an exciting stage of growth and development through far-sighted technical and vocational learning, such as T-Levels, Apprenticeship Standards, and the Digital Institute of Technology. We are ready and fully equipped to support the evolving needs of businesses so that they grow out of the impending recession with a highly skilled workforce. So for those not familiar with Activate Learning, if we can just skip to the next slide, please. Okay, so for those not familiar with Activate Learning, I just want to give you a little bit of context about us as an organisation. We're a group of colleges and an academy trust of schools covering the South, stretching from Banbury to Guildford. As you can see from this timeline, we've been busy in the last few years where we have seen the size of our group expand. So our colleges include Banbury and Bicester College, Blackburn Leeds Technology Campus, Bracknell Wokingham College and City of Oxford College, Farnham Sixth Form College and Guildford College, Marriswood Land-based College in Surrey, and of course Reading College. Additionally, I should increase my timeline slightly to the right there in my graphic to include the news that Ruskin College's recent merger with Activate Learning, the Oxford-based college, and the scale of delivery within Activate Learning will no doubt strengthen a truly exceptional adult education provision across the Thames Valley and more widely at a national level, so that we can continue to transform and improve more lives through learning. Okay. So in terms of how we are structured, we function within faculties that stretch across all of our campuses. And in each faculty, there is a design, sorry, a delivery director for each of our regions, including Oxfordshire, Berkshire, and Surrey, as well as a curriculum design director, myself for technology, and an external facing careers pathway director, Mark Byerly, who also joins the call today. Our faculties include apprenticeships division, academic and professional studies, which includes A levels, access to HE, business and health and social care, creative industries, including creative and performing arts and media, land-based, including provision at Banbury and at Merris Wood, and life skills, which includes foundation studies, supported foundation, including SEND and our adult and community provision. And we have lifestyles, which includes sports, public services, hospitality and catering, and of course, our sales technology. Without a doubt, Activate Learning, seeks to change lives through learning. And that's certainly our goal in technology faculty. And primarily, we want to just be outstanding at what we do. So just want to just talk about some of our strategic drivers. I mean, our five key drivers of globalization, technology, neuroscience, well-being, and sustainability inform our strategic planning and our curriculum development. Globalization remains a key factor in our business and in our partnerships. We continue to shape our curriculum and prepare students for global opportunities and adapt positively to employment in the post-Brexit marketplace. We are currently working closely with our international team and key employment partners to develop some exciting projects in India and China, to name a few, over the coming years. It's our intent to remain forward-leaning in our use of technology. We're working on a number of exciting capital build projects, and we will continue to invest in specialist equipment that enable our students to utilize the cutting-edge technology in modern environments. We are also working closely with our LEP partners across the region on a number of exciting projects and gaining industry insights about priorities for growth. We've learned, in terms of neuroscience, we've learned more about the brain in the last 10 to 15 years than all of human history. So neuroscience informs our learning philosophy and how we view learning and Activate Learning. More than ever, well-being is a critical component of our curriculum through initiatives such as the recovery curriculum and investment in our progress coaches, but also through a range of staff well-being initiatives too. And our final driver, sustainability, is critical to how we look to develop the curriculum going forward. Our technology students will be at the heart of developing clean growth and a sustainable built environment, learning about renewable energies and shaping sustainable solutions within the chosen industry. We would love to collaborate with any of you who feel equipped to support us, or indeed, advise your specialist knowledge and partner on any initiatives. So at Activate Learning, our curriculum is steeped in our learning philosophy. We ensure that we plan for engagement, motivation, and meeting the learner's emotional needs. Knowledge, skills, and attributes development is given equal value when planning and implementing our curriculum. We start where the learner is. Students are motivated through the learning experience that are built upon engagement and positive challenge. Real-world learning is a critical part of this, so collaboration with businesses is essential. Our intent is that students develop their behaviors and progress in their learning through a sense of belonging and purpose. Purposeful motivational dialogue helps our student helps our teachers, assessors, and our progress coaches to enable this. increased numbers of students will have the opportunity to develop their work skills, knowledge and attributes through work placements, project-based learning and employer co-delivery. We know that the brain is like a muscle. Sorry, just finally on that one. We know that the brain's like a muscle, and the more that you use it, the stronger it gets. So we believe in hard work and recognize the value in working through our failures so that we're constantly learning and improving. So I've created this graphic to demonstrate our curriculum intent, which is grounded in our learning philosophy and is based around our purpose of enabling a clear pathway for students to make progress through the different levels. At our lower level programs, we support students to make career choices and develop the behaviours and the confidence and the firm belief that they can make progress all the way through the levels. So in our level two trade programs, we support students to develop the technical craft skills and study focus so that they're ready to move on to apprenticeships, direct employment, or onto level three study. So we work closely with apprenticeship team to ensure that there are clear apprenticeship pathways for trade construction trade students to progress onto. Level two in engineering and computing and games design is the starting point in the journey as they learn the introductory technical skills and also develop English and maths through BTEC level two program, English and maths through GCSE and contextualize within their BTEC level two programs in order to make the progress to level three. Level three in our view is the minimum employability qualification for most engineering and digital industries. So with that in mind, we actively encourage students to advance into higher and technical learning. We will continue to strengthen our adult, community, leisure, employability programs. This is particularly pertinent that we support adults who will be looking to upskill and retrain throughout the post-COVID economic recovery. So I've outlined a number of our own drivers. We're also aware that of the national need to develop a curriculum that progresses students to be able to access and achieve the technical and vocational qualifications needed by employers within industry. The government have already signalled their intent over the years to reduce the amount of level three qualifications so that there is, you know, almost little else than A levels and T levels, you know, or at the very least, a reduction of the amount of applied generals such as BTECs. At Activate Learning, T levels will sit alongside BTECs. However, it's likely to change in the next few years, where we anticipate that T levels will replace BTECs in many of our areas, including digital and engineering. The efficacy of sub-level three qualifications outside GCSEs continues to be a focus for many further education providers. T-level transition programs at level two have been introduced with a clear focus on developing students to progress within their given pathway, moving the focus away from purely qualification outcomes. Many providers have opted to remove subject qualification from many of the level two programs, you know, within the transition programs. So many of these themes are highlighted, of course, in the government's white paper, the Skills for Jobs white paper, which outlines the intent of the economic growth through skills and lifelong learning. Activate Learning has always valued strong partnerships with employers. The white paper has reiterated to us the need for continued collaboration with employers and with other FE providers. We sincerely hope that if you're listening to these presentations today and not currently partnering with Activate Learning, that you'll be encouraged to do so in whichever capacity we can do to support. So in terms of the curriculum offered within the technology faculty, we view this as three main sector pathways of digital, engineering, including motor vehicle, and construction and the sustainable built environment. In order to meet the UK's skill gap, it is critical that we we accelerate a progression pathway towards higher technical and vocational learning. Each of these pathways should have an aspirational progression destination, whether that is university, higher technical or vocational programs, or apprenticeships, internally or externally, I should add. Our intent is to motivate students to progress beyond the minimum employability point in the pathway. Okay, next slide, thank you. So an example of a higher vocational or technical learning destination is shown here through our digital pathway. So the aspirational learning program in this case is the Institute of Technology. So my colleague Holly will cover this in more detail later on. We hope that for any young person hoping to establish themselves within the digital industry, the Institute of Technology will act as a beacon for them to aspire towards. Our intent is that it will enable us to define new learning cultures that blur the lines between industry norms and the learning environment. An example of that is how we bring agile, the sort of agile methodology into the classroom through EduScrum approaches. It's our intent, in line with the government's goals, to see an increased number of young people thriving in higher technical and vocational learning. We learn from our employer insights that higher level qualifications in technical subjects such as software development and data analysis have increased currency of a qualification to above level 3. So this informs us that in order to create a valuable pipeline for employers, that we should increase the number of students onto these programs and support with real world industry experience. Additionally, we should do all we can to enable, you know, for equity, the progression mobility of students below level 3, so that they can benefit from these rich specialist pathways. Our employment partnerships are key to that. So a quick note about T levels. These are the new courses which follow GCSEs and are equivalent to 3A levels. So these two-year courses, which were launched in September 2020, have been developed in collaboration with employers and businesses so that the content meets the needs of industry and prepares students for work, further education or study. Activate Learning will deliver digital production, design and development from September 2021, and also health and science partnering with the NHS In addition to that, from September 2022, we will increase the number of T levels on offer to include engineering and other vocational pathways from our other faculties. T levels have given our teams an opportunity to develop the curriculum and develop teaching, learning and assessment so students really do learn real world knowledge, skills and behaviours. Our partnerships with employers, especially the opportunity for students to apply their learning in industry, will be essential for them to succeed. Industry placements would be at the top of our wish list as we head towards launching these exciting programmes in September. So my final slide before I hand you over to colleagues, I've referred to the Institute of Technology. If you're not aware of what these Institutes of Technology are, they're the government's flagship programme designed to spearhead the delivery of higher technical education in STEM subjects. So IOTs are bringing together employers with FE colleges and universities into a new type of prestigious institution. So they aim to equip businesses with the skills that they need. There are currently 12 IOTs set up across the country, with a second wave currently out to tender. Activate Learning and partners in the South Central Digital IOT. We partner with Milton Keynes in that collaboration, and of course will remain open to any future development opportunities. Holly will give you a bit more detail, but I think it's fair to say that we're planning an exciting delivery model that will inspire students to progress towards and give employers that rich pipeline of specialist talent. So I hope I've been able to highlight to you how exciting things are currently within AFE. We look forward to forging valuable partnerships with yourselves in the near future. Thank you very much for listening. And I think I can hand you back to Adrian.
Scott, thank you very much indeed. And moving along, Holly Parrott. Okay, over to you, Holly. Thank you very much indeed. And thank you, Scott, for that great presentation. I've just populated the chat box by saying, of course, industry placement, top of our wish list. We'll all be keeping that very much to the fore of our minds as we're going through today for further follow-on engagement. Anybody who's particularly interested, of course, please populate your details into the chat function and we will reach back post the event. But for now, back to you, Holly.
Thank you. Next slide, please. And good morning, everyone. So my name is Holly Perrett. I'm the Partnership Engagement Manager at the Institute of Technology at Reading College. So just to kind of continue from Scott's introduction there, it's really exciting to have this opportunity for not only Reading College, but Oxford College as well. So we are the anchor FE partner to Milton Keynes, who will be the lead partner in the digital delivery that we will be offering from this year to all our learners. So it's really exciting to make up the South Central Institute. And we'll have three locations that we will be operating from. So for the Bletchley site will be for the Milton Keynes College learners, ourselves at Reading College, and then we will also have a base from our Oxford campus at Blackbird Leeds. And our aim over the next 5 years is to reach over 1,500 learners. So I wanted to talk through with you this morning about our values, which are really important to us, to make sure in everything we do, we include, we innovate, we connect, and we challenge. So we really want to make sure that these opportunities to progress either with internal students onto the IoT or attract new learners does mean everyone. It includes everyone. We really want these opportunities to be felt by everyone, that this is a route for them to progress onto and pursue a STEM career, which is really important that we're also promoting these opportunities. And we really hope that they're seen as a great way and a great tool for individuals to further their digital career, either with an apprenticeship or with a HNC, so a higher national certificate. Of course, we're going to be innovating. We're really going to be pushing out new technologies, new learnings, and making sure that our learners have that digital space to really be creative, imaginative, and really start coming up with different ways of learning and which will instill in their career going forward. As Scott mentioned, connection is really important to us. So working with various partners that we already have aligned with IoT, but also in this platform this morning, reaching out to all of you to talk about these opportunities and how you might want to engage with us as a faculty and as the IoT, whether you'd like to support the apprenticeship scheme to either attract new talent to your business or upskill existing employees, or perhaps you want to kind of shine a spotlight on your sector, on your business, whether you want to come in and do some talks, whether you would like to hold some projects. So really giving our learners that experience and engagement of real working scenarios, solutions, and just really having that engagement so they understand various roles and various insights into how people have made their careers, especially in STEM. So we're going to be challenging our learners, really going to be ambitious and really kind of pushing them forward so that when they leave us, they are set up with all the tools and skills they need to go on and have a successful career. And you'll see on the slide there, our aim is really three big key drivers for us, and it's to plug the digital skills gap, it's to understand the business needs, and it's to create unrivaled talent. So we know 88% of businesses find recruiting qualified individuals with up-to-date digital skills is a massive challenge. So part of the white paper with the introduction of the IoTs, we are set up to perfectly place to support the offering that we have with the level 4 and level 5 to make sure that learners are now equipped with the correct skills to go out into the sector and be employed, and we're also then meeting the needs of the business. And we know that there is a big kind of gap at the moment, especially in the Thames Valley, and we're really keen to work with more employers to hear about the needs of your business, maybe new trends. We know, for example, that the provision of AI is really up and coming, and that we're potentially going to need more skilled individuals to support businesses with that skill set. So this is an opportunity for you as businesses to really partner with us, help shape that curriculum and make sure we're setting up learners for success. And you can then tap into that talent pipeline. And I think what's great is being based at Reading College, we're perfectly positioned to help many businesses in the Valley and in the region to support you with young, ambitious, creative individuals that really want to continue their STEM career. So it's a great way for you to engage with them, to put a spotlight on your business and really capture, great young people who have the passion and the enthusiasm. And I know Mark from BMW will be talking later about tapping into that talent, and we really hope that we showcase that to you this morning as a way of opportunity of working with us at Activate. Now, we do have a big vision for equality, diversity and inclusion, and that is really important to us. It's something I'm really passionate about, and it's a driver from one of our values to include everyone. And when we say include everyone, we do mean everyone. These opportunities are open for all. And we really want to represent the communities we serve. So again, by having our basis at Reading College and also at our technology campus at Blackbird Leeds, we'll be fully supporting the communities and representing them with this offering to really push them forward in their careers, whether that's through the apprenticeship or whether that's through the HNC route. We really want to also shine a light on STEM careers and also make sure we're attracting and promoting more females into the sector, more BAME underrepresented groups and more neurodiverse individuals as well. So as I've mentioned, it's just a fantastic opportunity, an extension of learning that we will now have from this year. And we're really excited to really showcase this and really bring to light the opportunities it has for learners and for employers. So what makes us different? So many things, as you can see from that list, but I think it's the way that we're putting everything together. We're having the bespoke curriculum. We're also having really industry kind of field and knowledge of our trainers. So on the call this morning, we have Andy Bleach, who is one of our digital trainers, and he comes from years of experience of working in the sector. So he can really impart his knowledge onto the learners, talk about those real working experiences, solutions, problems, what skills they're going to need. And it's working with our range of employers. So as I mentioned, whether they're coming in to do inspirational talks, whether they're doing kind of project-based learning, they've got a big driver and focus and a blended approach to make sure that all our learners are set up for success. And they're going out and they are ready to really perform in the sector and have a fantastic career ahead of them. So our key partners that we have at the South Central Institute of Technology are listed on the screen for you. So we have Microsoft, KPMG, McAfee, Evidence Talks, Cranford University, and of course, Milton Keynes College, who is the lead partner. Now you'll see lots of logos to the right-hand side there. And as I mentioned, we're always keen to work with more employers and to engage with us in a variety of ways. So hopefully that is a takeaway from today's session, that perhaps you're thinking about how you could interact with us, how you could engage with our students and potentially set up your talent pipeline. Just talking through the products that we're going to be offering at the IoT, you'll see from this list the main pathways we're going to be concentrating on are security, software development and programming, data analytics, cloud networking, games and animation, and digital project management and change leadership. So this year for 2021, we're starting off quite small with a small offering for apprenticeships and HNC. And you'll see from the table there, it really does expand over the next 5 years. And that will also expand out to Oxford starting from September 2022. And today, I just want to kind of share with you the apprenticeships that we'll be offering, which might, again, be something you're supporting already, or might be a scheme you're looking into, or maybe this is a growth area of digital provision for you. So our digital apprenticeship pathways will be software developer, level 4, commencing in May, data analyst, level 4, commencing in June, and infrastructure technician, level 3, commencing in September. So do start to think whether you do have these provisions, whether this is something you'd like to talk to us further about. I'd be really keen to speak with you after today and to find out how this could possibly fit into your business needs, or whether you're looking forward at those 2022 or 2023 offering, whether perhaps cybersecurity next year is an option and an area you're looking into as a business, or digital project management going forward in 2023. Next slide, please. So if you are supporting the apprenticeship scheme already, you're very much aware of all the benefits, but perhaps this is something new for you and happy to talk through how this happens. But it really is a great way for you as a business to attract new emerging talent, which we can tap into here at the college. Or perhaps you'd like to use it as a retrain and retain existing employees that you have. You can utilise your apprenticeship levy, and of course there is a great incentive at the moment from the government for any businesses that are employing apprentices from now until the end of September, that you'll receive an extra £3,000 per apprentice as well. So there's that extra incentive. And as I mentioned, we do offer a blended online delivery and really focus on inclusive learning and opportunity for all. So I will pop my contact details in the chat box. Really hope that you reach out, and I look forward to chatting with you further about how digital and even other apprenticeships which we can support here at Activate Learning will work within your business. So thank you so much, and I'm now going to hand over to Jennifer to talk through her project with you.
Right, can everyone hear me okay?
That's fine, Jennifer, all good.
Brilliant, thank you. Hi, so my name's Jennifer Robinson. I am the project coordinator for the Industry Specialist Teaching and Knowledge Exchange Programme. So just want to tell you a bit more about that today. And thank you very much for joining us, of course, as well. So just to give you some background then, the Activate Learning group has won an AOC Beacon Award for its learning philosophy, which Scott was talking to you about earlier. So this motivational approach is integrated into all of Activate Learning's activities, along with its strategic plan, The Learning Reimagined. This places intense and deep business engagement at the forefront of development and the delivery of curriculum. This is envisaged in this project specification. So where it all began. In 2019, Activate Learning ran a small pilot programme, which saw some of our tutors undertaking industry placements with local employers, and in turn then sharing this newfound knowledge with their students. We depend on this engagement to ensure that the curriculum is up to date and relevant to industry. The success of this programme enabled the journey to continue in the form of the Industry Specialist Teaching and Knowledge Exchange programme. This was commissioned by the Thames Valley and Berkshire Local Enterprise Partnership and is part funded by the European Social Fund. The science, tech and engineering and maths industries are thriving, though there's currently a skills shortage, as Holly has mentioned. The future of the Thames Valley and Berkshire Leps economy depends on increasing the skills for STEM roles, so we need to prepare our young people to progress in this ever-growing sector. Thank you. With this in mind, a key objective of mine, as my part to play in this role, is to source and develop relationships with STEM SMEs exclusively in Berkshire. By connecting these businesses with tutors to work together on a multitude of offerings, this not only enhances teaching and strengthens what is delivered in the classroom, but it will give our local businesses a voice, the opportunity to co-teach their future talent and some well-deserved recognition when we shout about our success stories. So how can you get involved? Well, here we have a menu of opportunities. So there's a number of solutions open to everyone. We'd love to see more industry immersion for our tutors to enable them to expand and upskill their knowledge. Perhaps you could offer a placement to one of our fantastic teachers. And maybe from this organic conversation and relationship building, you may find that from getting to know your tutors through these placements, that you might discover a skills gap within your business. And if such a thing is identified, then let us help you. We want to know your business requirements and make sure that what we're teaching is necessary and relevant to the industry. Maybe you're up for something a bit different. Some project-based learning is invaluable to our students. They are challenged and prepared for real life experiences, and everyone can get involved. We'd love to see more of this. Also, sorry, thank you. I just wanted to touch on co-delivery. It's another fantastic way that you could get involved with us, from inspirational talks and masterclasses. So we want to hear more of you sharing your journey on how you came to be in your roles. And this can be really engaging for our young people and open their eyes to endless possibilities. And this type of interaction may even help you identify some future talent for your business. Thank you. So Activate Learning has joined forces with three other further education partners to deliver on this project. They are Newbury College, Activate Learning Education Trust, inclusive of the UTC and its Berkshire schools, and that is the Feel Green School, and the Windsor Forest Colleges Group. By delivering this project across multiple locations, we can broaden our reach and collaborate with a wider audience. So how to get in touch. If any of this has caught your interest, we'd love to hear from you. We have a dedicated hub for general inquiries on the project, and this is managed by our brilliant administrator, Waseem. Just so that you know, it's not managed by a robot, there's a real person at the end of it. And he'll be happy to guide you and advise you on a way to direct you in place of best support for you and your business. And then there's me. I represent the Activate Learning arm of this project. I'm based out of Bracknell and the Bracknell and Wokingham College and the Reading Colleges. I'll be happy to connect with you. My details are on the slide now and I'll pop them in the chat. So please feel free to reach out to me or connect with me on LinkedIn or Twitter if you prefer. And that rounds it up. But I just wanted to say, with nothing to lose and so much to gain, please do get in touch and let's start something amazing. I do welcome your questions. Thank you for listening. I'm going to hand back over to Mark.
Thank you very much for that, Jennifer. And thank you very much to Holly and Scott as well for some fantastic and very insightful presentations. So could I have the next slide, please? Thank you. So in terms of I think it's, you know, it's run, the whole theme of this morning is how do you get involved and how can we support each other in terms of working together. And it's, I think I'd like to reiterate a couple of points that certainly Scott and Holly made in terms of the FE Skills for Job white paper. Activate Learning is committed to strengthening those links between employers by supporting that pathway out of a post-COVID world and assisting businesses across the Thames Valley to respond to the challenges and of that economic recovery and providing those highly skilled students for those all important technical roles and talent pipelines. And And I think it's quite clear how we can do that. But I want to pick up on a couple of points that colleagues has referred to. I think it's important to highlight that we put employers at the heart of our core business so that education and training leads to jobs that can improve productivity and fill those all important skills gaps. And the point that Holly made about the 88% of the tech community, their biggest challenge is to fill those talent pipelines. And we know that's acutely felt across the Thames Valley. So we're very willing to work and collaborate with you to support to fill those gaps. I think as well it's that higher technical level qualifications, and the IoT is a fantastic opportunity for that. So it's a very, you know, it will become the flagship element of the technology faculty, and it very much will be aspirational for all learners of all levels. So whether they're level two learners aspiring to be in the IoT, or whether they're coming in at level four, level five on an apprenticeship or on one of our higher national digital technologies offers. But also it's not just, it's about ensuring that we represent the communities that we serve so they can access that training and learning flexibly throughout their lives. Because, you know, the whole FE sector is about lifelong learning. And I'm an advocate of that, as I know my colleagues in the call are. And it's ensuring that our communities are well informed about what we're doing so they know how to access that offer. And of course, all of that, it's important that all of that is underpinned by excellent teaching, learning and assessment. So there's a couple of opportunities there which have been highlighted throughout the call this morning in terms of how to get involved. And I wanted to go back to the point that Scott made in terms of the T-levels and the industry placements is very much top of our wish list. And I would welcome any conversations with you to how we can support each other and how you potentially support our students to become engaged in industry placements. And I've been involved in the T-levels pilots for quite some time now, working with employers like yourselves. And there are some fantastic opportunities that really benefit our learners and benefit the organisation as well. So they can make a real sort of meaningful contribution to your organisations on those 45-day placements. I'm really keen to, you know, support the neurodiverse in terms of coaching employers, and so they are able to recruit and manage those employees, which we all know are very important for the digital sector. But there's some great opportunities there, and I think, you know, the team will tell you that we've had some real success with project-based learning, mentoring, which we'll hear a little bit more about with Mark when we talk to Mark shortly. But I thank you very much for my colleagues for really raising the point and how we can work with you. And as I say, I'll put my details in the chat in terms of, but I'll be very willing to have a conversation with you. But without further ado, it gives me great pleasure to welcome Mark Massingham to the floor now in terms of having some kind of Q&A around how BMW access their talent pipeline within Accelerate Learning. So Mark, welcome. It's great to see you.
Nice to be on the call with everyone. Thank you for inviting me.
Mark and I have worked together extensively over the last few years on a variety of different projects, but I think it's fair to say that this project that we're currently working on is probably one of the most exciting ones that we've worked on over the years, and I'm sure you would agree with that, Mark. So I've got a couple of questions to ask you in terms of how you started working with the college and sort of the opportunities that it's led to.
So my role was created 4 years ago, last week, funny enough, and the view from the BMW standpoint was where we wanted to recruit apprentices from, our next generation of workforce, and our relationship with Activate is long-standing. It goes across many different levels of BMW, and what we quickly realized was we had a massively impressive college right on our doorsteps, a set of colleges that we wanted to tap in further. So one of my first challenges was obviously connect and branch into the apprenticeship and build that into Activate and tap into the talent that they are producing or you are producing.
So in terms of, because you are a very large employer, and we talk, you know, that reach certainly from the Oxford plant, but there are wider sort of opportunities across the group as well, aren't there, in terms of how students can get involved in those opportunities. So why is it important that activate learning. BMW engage with activate learning to then we engage with our students.
Yeah, I think this year is a good example. You know, everyone thinks of BMW as an engineering company, and obviously, you know, engineering is our bread and butter, but we do obviously have a massive business section, a massive IT section, which Activate obviously have, numerous students studying them courses across different campuses. My role, main focus is Oxford, but we do also cover Plant Swindon, obviously with the UTC and other establishments from the Activate umbrella, reaching into the Swindon area. It enables us to, again, have a positive partner in the area where we can tap into and really drill down to support Activate in developing these young individuals into their career paths, but also, you know, be smart and protect our interests and invest our time in and help create a better workforce moving forward.
So is that, it, you know, in some terms of some of the successes, is that very much around the engineering route that we've been working with you on over the last few years?
Yeah, the engineering one, there was a number of students that come from various different Activate settings into the business, across different plants as well. So the success is there. Where we are with the new, like you say, what we're talking about today is probably the most exciting partnership we've had. And, you know, we've had success before, so I can only imagine this is going to be even more successful, as it progresses through the years.
In terms of that, you know, the exciting, we're very much referring to the sort of the talent pipeline program that we've been working on extensively to shape it strategically and also start to implement the operational factors in involved in that. Would you like to just sort of talk to the audience around the work that we're doing around that talent pipeline and why it's so important?
Yeah, so it covers many, many different ways. One of the biggest, or from my point of view anyway, I know everyone have different views, but certainly the work experience we have with your students, so where your students come on site, you know, we've met these young people 3 or 4 times, we've identified them as people that we feel fit the criteria we want. We bring them into work experience and give them a real life taste. That's something which is really impressive. Certainly the engagement into the classroom, so something as simple as a presentation, and helping stretch the students' aspirations and make them realise that a worldwide brand that is on the doorstep is a real option as a pathway, a career pathway when they finish. You mentioned the mentoring scheme before. That is impressive. We've met some students. We've made it clear we like students, we support them. And being there as a mentor to offer help and guidance is something we're very proud to do. And there's a number of other ways. It covers so many different pathways we could be all day talking about it.
Yeah, because I think when you say about the work experience and it being real life, it is absolutely real life, because those students are starting at 7 o'clock in the morning, aren't they? And, working a real life shift alongside colleagues that are doing the job on a daily basis. So that does, show a level of commitment from the learners. And I know that some learners have travelled quite far and have stayed overnight during that week to ensure that they are at the plant at 7 o'clock in the morning, ready to go to, really engage in that experience. And as well, I know that you've done quite a lot of work in terms of coming in to the college, and you talked about your careers presentations. But also, I think for me as well, one of the standout points was the whole sort of application surgery and the interview support that you provided along sort of side the mentoring scheme really was really a defining moment for some of our learners in terms of them being able to sell themselves, in the right manner. So they were given the opportunity to apply for a BMW apprenticeship. I know some of them have been successful as a result of that.
Yeah, what we tried to do is a body of work where, we engage with the student, quite early in their Activate journey. We make them aware of the offers that are available to them. And we can build that interest through site tours, interactions with our apprentices, interaction with other managers, really give them a rounded insight into what the BMW offer is, what the BMW apprenticeship/career will be, Certainly the on-site tour is something that's massive. We've done many different events, you know, where actually students are always in high attendance. You know, and it builds into when we've identified someone and they've declared their interest and they're really engaged, you know, we do support them all the way through to patients. You know, it's fantastic what we have been able to see over the last couple of years. We've identified and worked with over the journey, go through the application process and then join us, and you know, and now in their second or third year with us. So it's a piece of work, it's a body of work that is working and is very successful, and it's only going to get stronger with, you know, how we move forward working with Activate.
Absolutely, which I think is really important to highlight the sort of other benefits that you find by partnering with ourselves in terms of that local talent, you know, and representing the communities you serve. So are there any, there are a number of other benefits that you find from doing that. Would you just like to explain those?
Yeah, so I was actually talking to Holly about this the other day. One area which is massive for us, we obviously do some work with some schools, and we identify talent there which maybe are not quite ready for us. Maybe they haven't quite got the grades, or maybe they want to gain more experience, and we signpost them to Activate because we can keep an eye on them, we can watch them grow, we can, you know, stay or have that regular contact with them whilst they're going for Activate. And, you know, we can have various different interactions with them and build a massive one for us. And obviously, Activate is such a big part of the community around our plant. You know, it's less than a mile away, it's walking distance. So, you know, it really is an ideal partnership we can tap in. You know, we've got lots of corporate responsibilities in the local area which Activate help us achieve and partner us on. There's many, many different groups in the bio of working with Activate.
I know that you've worked on a range of initiatives specifically to recruit females into STEM roles. Do you want to say something about that?
Yeah, so every year we do an initiative called Girls Go Technical. We still did it. You know, even with the COVID implications, we turned it to virtual. And what we have with Activate is, you know, I know we have a shared drive to increase the number of female students in the sector. It's fantastic because we have been able to speak to and invite and encourage the students within your classes to join. It's fantastic from our point of view to have, you know, the biggest education provider at college level supporting us in our targets and in increasing that female interaction into our sector. So, you know, we really do tackle on that, and the access we get to various different countries is fantastic in supporting our.
I mean, it's absolutely perfect. It's one of our key drivers, as you know, within Activate, and certainly within the technology faculty, to increase that the profile of females at BAME and those neurodiverse students, give them the access and the opportunities to be able to progress into the careers that they so willingly want to. Mark, I think that's been a fascinating insight and great to see that BMW is so supportive of everything that we're working together on a great partnership with that, you know, accessing the talent of the future and ensuring that we invest our time with them so they are able to progress into careers within BMW. But thank you very much for your time, Mark. It's been very insightful, and I can look forward to continuing to work with you over the next few years.
No, thank you for inviting me, and hopefully we will encourage more employees to join what is a very, very fantastic partnership for us.
Yeah, and absolutely. We'll go from strength to strength as we collaborate further and work on different opportunities that materialise. But thank you very much for your time, and thanks very much, Mark.
No problem. Thank you.
Gentlemen, absolutely fantastic and very inspiring. Thank you very much indeed for sharing these last few moments, which I'm sure, if not already, people will be spurred on to pick up that conversation and understand more of the opportunity available for them by leaning in further to all of what's going on within Activate Learning. Thank you very much.
Thank indeed. You very much.
Thank you. And moving on to our next slide, there are a number of events coming up which I just wanted to signpost two. And the first is actually, we've got our flagship event in the next couple of days. It's the Windsor Debates. And it's all about sustainability over the course of the 2 days, Monday and Tuesday. We're very excited, as you can appreciate, given the normal prominence that Windsor Castle would enjoy. This year, unfortunately, because of COVID, we're not going to be in the grounds of Windsor Castle, but we are certainly going to be broadcasting the lead, if you like, on or from the venue itself. But there are a number of opportunities available for those who are interested to lean in further to this conversation. And I guess we've just been hearing from an employer who is very much involved in the whole area of sustainability and, of course, the impact of technology for that future pathway on CO2 emissions, as well as other areas of sustainability, will not be lost on anybody in this particular environment right now. We're delighted to signpost to a couple of our keynote speakers. You'll see here Heathrow represented. We've got Chief Carbon and Strategy Officer Andrew McMillan. And we've also got the Director of Telecommunications Integrated Applications from the European Space Agency, no less, is also going to join. We've got Jackie MacDonald, who is sustainability lead from one of our business alliance partners, Boehringer Ingelheim, who, as an employer of choice, will also be familiar to those on this call. And we've also got the president of Gold Standard.
He's back. Hi, Adrian. Are you back?
Okay. Hello. Okay. And we've got Uwe de Boer from the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, former executive secretary, is going to also contribute over the course of the 2 days. Again, space extremely limited, as you can appreciate. If there are opportunities, we'd certainly be delighted to receive any indications of interest, and we will do our utmost to accommodate. And then also, if I could, just signpost to April the 14th. We've got a business leaders forum and continuing in the sustainability theme that's been led by our colleague, Sarah Paris, Views from a Business Leader, Your Chariot Awaits. And for those who are interested in rugby, Martin O'Faya is heavily involved in the sector and a specific interest in the electric vehicle usage model. So if that is of interest to you, we would encourage you to please, again, send your expression of interest to myself or indeed, as I say, Sarah Paris at tvchamber.co.uk. Today's event has been recorded. It will be available in the coming days at our webinar library. And for details of this event, obviously, and future events, please do refer to thamesvalleychamber.co.uk. I'd like to extend a warm thanks to everybody who has attended today's event. And obviously, it has been supported by my colleagues in marketing, who've done a fantastic job as always. And to our partners today, Activate Learning and BMW and their associated teams. It's been a real pleasure to work with you all. Thank you very much indeed. As we draw to a close, I wish you all continued safekeeping in this time of COVID and have a great weekend. Sun is shining today, folks. Hopefully you get the opportunity to enjoy. Thank you very much indeed. And we look forward to speaking to you all again soon. Take care.
Thank you very much, Adrian.
Thank you very much indeed, Adrian.
Thanks, Adrian. Thanks, everyone.
Cheers.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Great to see you all. Thank you very much.